Hi, I'm Greg Tito.
And I'm Alina Koch with your guide to this week's hottest news.
This is the Escapist News Wrap. This week, NASA took the trouble to state it had not made a big discovery on Mars. The lead scientist behind the Curiosity rover mission made a few comments during an NPR interview, which implied something very big was uncovered on the red planet. He said, quote, "This data is going to be one for the history books. It's looking really good." What? Did that mean they found life? Sweet! NASA followed up with a statement, though, basically saying, hold your horses, he was just really excited about data. He does this all the time, it's no big whoop. Whatever it is the rover discovered will be announced on December 3rd. I'm betting on a battered book with "Don't Panic" written in large, friendly letters on the cover.
A Japanese woman smashed her new husband's virtual girlfriend as part of the couple's wedding ceremony. For those of you unfamiliar with the genre, Japanese dating sims like the Groom's Love Plus allow you to charm and seduce an AI programmed to look and act like a real girl. The wedding ceremony was already a little strange when the couple invited the virtual girlfriend to the nuptials, going so far as to give her a seat at the reception. The bride surprised the groom with her idea to destroy the cartridge of Love Plus in front of all their friends and family, but the groom readily agreed to participate in the symbolic smashing. Of course, he could just buy a new copy of Love Plus, but hopefully he'll wait until after the honeymoon.
The future strategy for CPU manufacturer Intel might limit the choices for building your own PC gaming rig. The new chips produced by Intel, codenamed Broadwell, will not fit into the socket of a motherboard from any manufacturer. You'll have to buy a whole card from Intel. Intel owns almost 80% of the CPU market, so the strategy for Broadwell will effectively prevent a third-party market from flourishing. That's bad for PC gamers, but Intel did state that its next series of chips, codenamed Skylake, will use a socket architecture. Will custom PC rigs be hamstrung by then, or will rival AMD fill the niche? I don't know, but I do want to stress that the guy who comes up with codenames has the best job ever.
Ian McKellen and Patrick Stewart will return as Magneto and Professor X in the next X-Men movie. Bryan Singer, the director of the first two X-Men films and producer of X-Men First Class, announced that the two British thespian powerhouses will reprise their roles in X-Men Days of Future Past. Also returning are James McAvoy and Michael Fassbender, who played those roles in First Class, so it's clear we'll have some time bending going on. The Days of Future Past comic story follows a bleak alternative timeline with the mutants oppressed by the robot Sentinels. Hugh Jackman is in talks to appear in the film as well. To sum up, basically everything about the movie sounds awesome.
The Wii is getting a smaller brother, but only in Canada. It will retail for $99 and comes with a Wii remote and one nunchuck controller, also red. As to why it's available only in Canada, that's completely up to speculation. Perhaps Nintendo wants to test how a cheap alternative to the Wii will fare, or if customers will be confused with the Wii U, the Wii, and the Wii Mini on store shelves all at the same time. What better place to test out business plans than the Great White North? Soon we'll hear about McDonald's testing out the McMoose Burger in Toronto.
PC gamers desperately want Rockstar to release Grand Theft Auto 5 for Windows. To recap, the last Grand Theft Auto game did come out on PC for nearly 8 months after the console. Rockstar hasn't even promised a delayed release this time around. So far, more than 100,000 gamers have signed the online petition pleading Rockstar not to abandon the, quote, most powerful platform of the PC. The petition says the mods for GTA 4 were, quote, some of the most insanely fun times you can have. I'm not sure Rockstar will be convinced to port GTA 5 to PC-based on mods, seeing as the hot coffee controversy all began when a PC gamer dug up the hidden sex code. Still, it's a shame that the PC is being ignored for such a popular franchise.
Ending this week's news wrap on a legal note, a tattoo artist is suing publisher THQ for the digital representation of ink on a fighter in UFC Undisputed. Carlos Conda has a distinctive tattoo of a lion on his lower torso, and the developers recreated it in the video game. The artist argues that he holds the copyright for the tattoo, not the wearer, and as far as the copyright law goes, he's not wrong. The artist's lawsuit demands all the profits associated with the tattoo's use, as well as damages for using an image of his tattoo without his permission. It doubly sucks for THQ because they recently unloaded the UFC license onto EA. They won't likely earn very much profit from UFC games going forward, so this lawsuit just digs the struggling publisher into an even deeper fiscal hole.
And that's your news wrap for this week.
Stay tuned to escapistmagazine.com for all the latest gaming news.